Praise the Lord, church. Praise Master Jesus. My name is Sister Grace Chukwuka. The Lord, I am here to thank the Lord for his healing and deliverance over my life. It's been so much to me. He delivered me one from the affliction of the fingers. The three fingers, let me start with that. The three fingers troubled me for years, shocking with pains. I couldn't hold the chalk and writing on the board. I believed God. I said, God, whatever be this arrow, Lord, remove it from my life. Remove it. They will not harm my fingers. I will use this finger to work and to serve you. I believe God and hold God to hold on to the Lord. This happened for almost 3 years. When it terminated, when it vanished, I couldn't remember. It was when Daddy began to call on such afflictions. I said, wow, that which was happening to me on this finger, God, hi, it's reminded me now. I will testify. Number two, remind me. 2, the Lord visited me in my room. Little me, and the one room boys quarter where I was living in FGC, worry then. And as it is in Zechariah 4 verse 6, he said, grace is not by might, it's not by power. Lie down on your bed, and immediately that which seems to be mountain, which the Lord says, you mountain, you'll be made plain, was melted by the power of the Holy Ghost. And it fell out of my eyes in three blocks of water. And then I said, Lord, thank you. I opened my eyes and I saw. I said, God, let me see you and worship you. And what I saw was the cloud in my room. It was in the night. And the cloud was just flowing round the bulb of my room. I just fell down. I began to worship the Lord in my one room by squatter. As at then, the Lord is good, my brothers and sisters. The third one. Remind me again. What was that third one? The third one was, will I call it an arrow? Of course, yes. I have been receiving that. I'm not ignorant of the devices of the enemy. But there was this very sharp one, excruciating one in my right hand hip. That's troubled me for some days. I say, God, what is this? Return this thing to the owner. Return this thing to the owner. Lord, it should be out of me. It should be out of me. I was finding it difficult to climb this small staircase then until I fell under anointing 3 weeks ago. And when this thing now disappeared, I didn't even know. Daddy said, we will not know when they go away. I am here. I'm a living witness of the goodness of the Lord in my life.
Put your hands together for Jesus. She's a bundle of testimony. God, divine intervention in the life of our sister. Make the hand better for Jesus. Make it better for Jesus. You tell the church your name and what the Lord has done for you.
Okay. Good evening, church. My name is Rosemary Onyekoro. Last Wednesday, there was a pronouncement by the senior pastor that anybody that is owing you will pay you your money. I claimed it, and I was trusting God that it will come to pass. On Thursday, there was a man that was owing us, and he made an undertaking. He wrote an undertaking that he was going to start paying from January till probably July for him to clear the debt. So I didn't see him January. February, I didn't see him. March, surprisingly, on Thursday, after declaration, they came to call me and told me, oh, so-and-so person is waiting for you downstairs. So I rushed downstairs thinking that he came with the money. He now said, oh, madam, I just came to acknowledge that I know I've been owing you, but I just want to tell you that part of the money that were being owed by the federal government has been released, and very soon I will clear your debt. I just came to acknowledge that I'm still coming back to see you. I said, there is no problem, no problem, since you have acknowledged. On Friday, a woman was owing us some money that ran into 60. That was since last year. So promised that he was going to pay last year, that she was going to pay last year. She didn't pay. She kept on turning us upside down. On January, she brought a debtor check to be cleared on in February. That is the last month of about 27th of February. We went and put in the check, and the check failed. On Friday, I didn't call her. My spirit said I shouldn't even call her, but I presented it before the Lord. Then after that declaration on Wednesday, on Friday, the accountant called me to say, oh, madam, there's a good news. This woman brought teller to that amount. I just want to come and return the glory to the glory of the Lord. It is good to trust the Lord. It's always good to be in the presence of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Make the hand better for Jesus. That woman came under pressure, and that which was holder was released. For somebody today, God is releasing that which belongs to you in the name of Jesus. The church your name and what the Lord has done for you.
Praise the Lord, church. My name is Shidin Mali. I came to testify on behalf of my brother. There was a delay on his settlement. He served a man for 7 good years. So at the end of the service, he's supposed to be settled. But the man accused him of stealing his goods and his money. So when we asked my brother, he said no, that he did not. So my brother had to come back from Lagos without being settled. So we began.
That was 7 years after he had served his master, and it was time for being settled. And then story came up. And then he had to return back from his place of service without being settled.
So when we began to pray, the Lord revealed to us that the man is an occultic man, that that's how he has been killing. He wants to kill my brother. He doesn't want to settle him. So we started praying. We started begging God for intervention. So last year during the Oran Freedom Program, I tabled it before the Lord. I said, God, my brother cannot serve 7 good years and he will not be settled. So last year in November, entering December, the man called and said that he will settle my brother without being paying him. So we said no, that he cannot be settled like that, that he must be paid. So my mother said that he just carry his money. Maybe he can make him mad, or he will not succeed, or he will not prosper in his business with the money. So I said, I told my mother, no, that he has been served. He must be settled. So I kept on praying to God. Ending last month, February, my brother called me that the man has sent him 200,000. That he was even begging him that there was no money, that he would have settled him the 1 million normal settlement, but because there's no market and there's no money, he has to manage this 200,000. So I've come to give God.
Put your hands together for that divine intervention. For somebody again tonight, God will put everyone under pressure that is holding that which belongs to you in the name of Jesus. Tell the church your name.
Thank you. My name is Jubilee Madu.
All right, she said I should take the testimony for her. These are Sister Jubilee Madu. She is here testifying on behalf of her mother. She said the mother has been working for a long time now, and for 10 years, she wasn't promoted. That every time it was time for promotion, they will always tell the woman, there is no vacancy, you can go, while others are being promoted. And she presented that case, and in December 2019, the mother was called for a promotion exam. And January this year, she was promoted. Make that hand better for Jesus. Number two, she said that she has been suffering from this excruciating ear pain, left ear, and once in a while, it bleeds. And he said she came into church last Sunday, and declarations were being made, and she checked herself. She just heard a pop in the ear, and today, the bleeding has stopped, the pain has stopped, and she can hear clearly now. Make that hand better for Jesus, because divine intervention is coming somebody's way today in the name of Jesus. Make that hand better for Jesus.
Make those hands bigger for Jesus. You believe you are next in line for your own testimonies, you do them bigger and louder for Jesus. For somebody here, whatever belongs to you in the hand of the devil shall be released in a hurry in the name of Jesus. And for anyone trusting God for bodily healings, as we have had all manner of testimonies, it is also released in Jesus' name.